It's Friday, salsa. Okay. We have to make a couple of boots. His forward boot is eight foot beam, and it's four poles. His rear boot is 8 foot beam, and it's only two poles. So basically, they're 2 yards apiece. So I'm going to cut four pieces, 36 inches. So it'll be 4 1-yard pieces. And I have the Pacific Blue. Doesn't have to be super exact, but we're gonna go ahead and put down a hard line. Friday, salsa day. Alright. Took the opportunity to break down all of my thread tension, clean them out, defluff them, and then re-thread with black. Same thing on the bottom. Tried to clean out the hook and tidy things up a little bit. The repair guy is due to come in and he pulls the baskets and does a thorough cleaning. After a clean and disassemble, or disassemble and clean, I like to check that thread tension. I put things back where they were as far as, this one's just a little out of flush, this one's about flush, this is where they were. But it almost feels like this one still has a little bit too much tension. Let me back it up. three clicks. Whew, man, my table is dirty. Look at all that. Wow. Get these fabricated into boots. I need these folded into quarters. Put right on the seam. Just gonna sell right ruler. Here we go. They are correct. They are inside out, so we can mark on them and be okay. So we're gonna call this one the 4, and this will be the aft. We have to get our Bimini boot template. All right, so we have the forward boot is 8-foot beam with 4 poles. So there's 4 poles that I have to wrap around. We're going to say that's 4 inches. So we're going to have to actually add 8 inches. Plus the half-inch seam allowance, we're going to go 9 inches. So 8'9". 8'9" is 105. And if we cut that in half, 52.5. We're gonna say 53. 53.
Okay, 53.
I need a sip of soda. Need some of that Big K. All right. The forward boot, 8-foot beam, and 4 poles. So So each one of those poles is 7/8. We're gonna go an inch. So 4 on each side would be an addition of 8. And a 1/2 inch seam allowance on each side would be 9. So we're looking at 8 foot 9. 8 foot 9 inches is 105. We're gonna go to 106 to make it easy to divide in half. That'd be 53 would be half of 106. 53. We said 4. Now the aft. The aft boot is 8 foot with 2 poles. 2 on each side would be a total to add 4 inches, 5 for the seam allowance. 8 foot 5. 8 foot 5 is 101. Again, to make it easier to cut in half, we're going to go 102. This would be 51 inches. I like to make them a little longer than my jig there. Give me a little extra skirt going down the sides. And there we go. Now we need to head over to cut. Nothing but a party. Scoop down here away from my cut line. Forward. We want the outside of the forward. I can tell by the seam, this is the outside. We're going to do this without. It's only 8 foot beam. A 10 footer should be plenty. Yes, it is. I have a tail. Okay. I'm going to do this freehand. I'm not going to tape it. I'm just going to go for it. Check the stitch. Stitch length's at a 5. We're good to go. And again, we got to leave room for the poles, so we're not going to run the zipper all the way down. Zipper at all. Just letting the zipper kind of slide through this hand. I'm not trying to stretch it. If I start to see too much blue, I push with this hand to push it out. On the tail end, you can go farther because it just won't zip down. That's fine. It's not like the starter where you have to get it closed enough to get it started. Here it's just a run out end. So somewhere in the, you know, again, we're wrapping around poles. We got to have enough room. Ooh, this blade's almost shot. Again, anytime you've got Ross Umbrella Edge next to a zipper, even though that's going to be folded to the inside, it will start to fray in those strings. This blue stinks. The strings will get longer and longer and longer, and they'll keep getting caught in the zipper. And may jam it up to the point where the customer can't get it off. And they'll use a pocket knife and they'll cut it off. Yes, I've seen that done. And if he used a little bit more care when he cut it off, I could have fixed it. But he butchered it, so they needed a new boot. But the theory behind the Bimini boot is it's the sacrificial. They don't take a lot of material to make. And if it gets tore up, that's all right. There we go. Pole. Still turned down a little. Let's go up one notch. There we go. Oh, now we're cooking. Thank you. Oh, this is a song they can't find the end to. Everybody gives it a shot. All right, we need to fold it and turn it. There. And here the key is to line up the bottoms. Of course, I've already hemmed this one, so it's a little off, but that's gonna tell you where to start the zipper. Go right there. Nice when those two line up. The seam from the top and the seam from the bottom means it's folded in half and it's not split. Thank you. these over. That way I don't have to bind them later. Find it, burn it, or bury it. We're gonna bury it inside the Bimini. Over there and sew it shut. And of course, we don't have to use the double stitch on these ends, but it just means that my Bimini boot will stand up to twice the wind that another's will. So if you only have a single stitch, I would take two passes. Because these things do tend to get a lot of abuse as they're being towed down the road. Looks to blow it up like a parachute and just rip the seams completely out of it. I like to hard burn this one because I see a lot of Bimini boots come in for repair. And this area here is just full of strings. I like to hard burn ours before they go out. It's going to take it a while to start fraying. There we go, good hard burn. That's it. Turn it right side out, it's done. picked this method up from the one guy online, and it works quite well. And a lot of times you can make these with scraps if you need to. But then it starts to look a little quilt and patchwork. But, bam, there it is. And then I will write with hard pencil on the inside, fore and aft, because for him, they're not going to be interchangeable. Okay. And a couple of stops. Females on the bottom. And we want the stop, or the lock to be on the outside. Alright, so we got the pull, we got the stops. Turn right side out. And this is a lake-bound boat, so we won't be able to see it on the boat till later date.